Many people don't know this, but Clay actually has a Chrome extension that allows you to scrape pretty much any website on the internet and import the data into Clay for further enrichment. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to find websites, structure them within the Clay Chrome extension, and then eventually import that data into a Clay table for whatever use case you might want.
The very first thing you're going to want to do is, of course, download the Clay Chrome extension so you can scrape any of these websites. The easiest way to do this is just to go to the Chrome Web Store and then type in Clay, and Clay will be the first result that comes up. And then you can just add it to Chrome from there. Just connect your already existing Clay account and you will be good to go. Now that we're all connected, let's go to a website that we can scrape. In this case, I decided to use the Y Combinator website. This is a great source of leads if you're trying to reach out to startups that were just funded recently. All you have to do to scrape these websites is to first click on the Chrome extension, go to select data, unless of course it is already mapped out by Clay, which is the case with a lot of really popular websites. And next you're gonna click select data to add from paid and then select a list. You can see here that we have all of these different Y Combinator companies listed out here. And if you hover over, you can see that it tries to identify each HTTP sector. What we're going to do is we're going to click two matching attributes in the list. So for example, we're going to click the Airbnb and then the Instacart names. Once you do that, you'll see here that it sends you right here to an untitled list. We'll name this Clay YC list. Next, we're going to click select an item attribute to add. Essentially what this does is it allows you to select an attribute that you want to scrape and it will programmatically detect that within the list. So in this case, we will first select the name of the company. And you'll see right here, it extracted Airbnb. We can put this as company name. When we click add attribute, you'll see right down here, we have a huge list of companies that now was scraped via Clay. We'll do this with a few different attributes now. We'll do company description, we will do location, and we will even do the YC batch that they were in. Now that we've added this large list of companies and the YC batch associated with them, we can also add images. So if you click on the logo right here and go down to image, you will see that it extracts the image and we can put that as company logo. All right. So now we have a pretty exhaustive list of these companies and their names. So what we're going to do is we are going to create this list and name it YC list and save the changes. After this, you can easily get this list and add it to your workspace by just clicking add workspace. And if we wait just a second, the list will populate with the information required. Something else that's important to note is it can pick up just as many companies as you're able to scroll for. So if you keep scrolling, it will pick up more and more and more companies. I'm scrolling quite a bit right here. And you can see while this table only has 40 rows, if I click this right here, it will now load us up 180 companies. So you can just keep scrolling and as long as the computer can see it, Clay will pick it up as well. Okay, so next is a really cool feature within Clay that a lot of people really overlook or don't use. And I highly, highly recommend you check this out. So if you click on the Airbnb page right here, you are now sent to ycombinator.com/companies/Airbnb. And that's important to note in a second. There is a ton of extra information here, including the founders of the company, their LinkedIn accounts, their descriptions. And you can of course reference this in an email while using Clay. So it's really, really important information that you can use. So how do we scrape these? Well, first what I'm going to do is I'm going to click the Clay Chrome extension once again, and you'll see here that we already have the Y Combinator company page mapped out. How do we get this information from the company page and export it into Clay easily? Because of course, it's not a list, it's an individual page, and we want to do this programmatically. We don't want to have to do this over and over and over again with all of the different companies. We're going to notice here that the domain is always ycombinator.com/companies and then the company name. And you'll see here that there's a dash instead of a space, and of course, it's all lowercase right here. What we're going to do is you can see here we have our company names in this Clay column. Well, Clay has a really cool thing called a formula, and it allows you to format data whatever way you would like. What we can do here is we can say get company name, make it completely lowercase, and replace any spaces with a dash. And if we generate the formula, perfect. This is exactly what we're looking for. And so we're going to put company name for domain. And then we're going to go over here and copy this structure right here. We'll paste it right here. And instead of this company name, we are going to add a column and use our formula right here. So you'll see now that each one of these is going to pop out a unique domain for the Y Combinator companies. So we have Y Combinator companies, Airbnb, Instacart, DoorDash, Coinbase, etc. We're going to call this our YC domain. Now we have the company name, their batch, the description, their location, their logo, and the link to their YC company page. Now what we're going to do is we're going to extract information from these individual company pages and import it into our Clay table. Click enrich data and then just put get data and you'll see it right here. And if we put this URL into the integration and run our first 10 rows, it should find all the information that we're looking for that was mapped out previously in the YC company page. And so if we click right here, we now have all of this information about the company. We can map out their website. We can map out their founder social medias, the founder descriptions, their domains, just map out a couple different things. We will throw in the website as a column. We will throw in the founder's social media as a column. And suddenly we have a ton of information that we can now use to find emails. We can also use this stuff to be referenced in OpenAI integrations. We have a plethora of possibilities and all we had to do was use Clay to scrape these pages. pages and the individual pages associated with them. Clay can actually pick up links programmatically as well. So if you click here and we add an attribute, we can actually add the link right here and it will send us straight to the link that it's sending us to. So you can also just export that and do the exact same thing with the get data from page integration. And voila, you have a ton of information about people or companies or whatever entity you want to find within a website, easily scrapable via Clay.
Feel free to drop a subscribe or a comment. Feel free to reach out to me on LinkedIn if you have any questions, and happy prospecting.